there's nothing more frustrating than being really into someone, and then when you contact them, they just don't contact you back. And if you're feeling this way, like if you're feeling really frustrated, I get a lot of women in our community that run into situations like this, and a lot of them tell me that they get really frustrated, they get angry, they get upset, they get confused. And if you're feeling this way, you're not alone. This is a pretty normal way to feel in this situation. I've experienced this before. Most people that I know have experienced this before. And a lot of the women in our community have experienced this before. And personally, I don't know how you would not get upset or frustrated in a situation like this. And so what does this even mean? Like, what does it mean when you send somebody a text message and they don't really respond to it? Well, what it means is that it's kind of a sign of disrespect, and not in a way necessarily like a malicious sign of disrespect, like he's trying to like hurt you or something, but it just shows that he's not prioritizing you and he's not appreciating you and he's not valuing you, which can sound kind of like he's trying to hurt you in some way or whatever. But what it really means is that he just doesn't see it. He doesn't see the value in you. He's not realizing how amazing and wonderful and beautiful and attractive of a woman that you are. And so he is doing all these things because of that. And so what's the biggest mistake that women make in this situation? When you're in a situation like this and you're feeling frustrated and you're like upset and you're not sure really what to do, it can be really easy to try to force the situation. And that's the biggest mistake that you can possibly make, is trying to force something, trying to manipulate something, coming from the space of fear, and then, you know, trying to get control over the situation by trying to kind of manipulate it like it's some kind of chessboard, and you're kind of putting these different chess pieces around and you're trying to force a situation to happen. So what you don't want to do is do anything like that. What will end up happening is it will destroy any kind of relationship or dating situation that you do have. If he realizes that this is something that you're doing, he'll probably end up leaving, or he'll start playing games with you. And that's the opposite of what you want to have happen. So other mistakes that you might end up making doing this. One, we already talked about trying to play games with him. Or another one is shaming him or attacking him or telling him that he's playing games with you. Something like that. Because a lot of times when women think or guys think that a person is playing games with them, what's actually happening is they're really just not that into you, or they're not that attracted to you. And so attacking him or shaming him will just drive him further away. And what you want to do, if you really like this guy and you want things to be mended with him, is to not do that and to give him some space instead. So the next mistake you can make is smothering him with messages, asking him what's wrong or why he hasn't responded, or is he angry with you, or anything like that. We get a lot of women that do that kind of thing in these kinds of situations, and that really just, it destroys everything. It'll just drive him out of your life. So you don't want to do that. Another one is kind of coming back with, like, once he does respond, coming back with needy or clingy or self-deprecating behavior, text messages, or some kind of pity party thing that you do. That doesn't work as well. It just makes him feel like you're kind of low self-esteem and that you don't really value yourself, and that's just not a good way to go in general. It can get attention, but it's not good attention, and it's not attraction, and it's not what you actually want. Another thing is trying to ignore him back or trying to get revenge on him. I mean, obviously, if he ignores you and all of a sudden you hate him and you want to push him out of your life, then ignoring him back or trying to inflict revenge on him, you know, if that's just what you want to do to make yourself feel better, whatever, but it's not going to help your situation in any way. The last mistake that you can make before we go on to what you should do instead is refusing to look at your own behavior as something that may have turned him off and driven him away. And you know, one of the things that you might have done is some of the things from the mistakes that we talked about earlier. And it's great to think like, oh no, I'm perfect and I don't make any mistakes and I should just be able to do whatever I want to. But there's human psychology and human behavior here at play. And I'm going to be talking a lot about that in my new program that I'm going to be coming out with here in a couple of weeks that I'm giving away for free, which you can get if you join our community. And so it's going to be a really awesome program.